West, and this is Studio 7 on YouTube West. And today I'd like to talk about a fantastic movie in my book. It was panned by the movie critics. It was limited in the movie theaters, and I can understand why, because again, I'm going to tell you right off the bat, it's a 6 out of 7 movie. However, it's a must-see in my book, which is always why I'm telling you about it. But not only is it a must-see, it's a sports movie from 1992 called Wind. Now, it stars Matthew Modine and Jennifer Grey. It has some excellent people in the background. It has Stellan Skarsgård, Rebecca Miller, Cliff Robertson, and Jack Thompson. The music is by Basil Poulos, who also did the music for The Hunt for Red October. I'm almost going to go backwards to go forwards here with Wind and tell you a couple of things right off the bat. First of all, Cliff Robertson is nearing what we call the end of his career. He's pretty old by the time he does this movie. He's known for playing John F. Kennedy in PT-109. This guy has been around for a long time. He's always done very interesting roles like Charlie or The Naked and the Dead. But in this movie, he gets to strut his stuff as a skipper of an America's Cup boat. Jack Thompson plays the Australian skipper of another boat for the land down under, and I dig Jack Thompson. He's fun. Smiling Jack is a great time. And if you've ever seen The Man from Snowy River, you've seen him in there, and he's wonderful. So don't miss these two performances inside this movie. Rebecca Miller, cute. Not as cute as Jennifer Grey was at this time. Jennifer Grey before the nose job. Oh my goodness. If you like Dirty Dancing, ladies, you'll love this movie. Guys, if you like Jennifer Grey in Dirty Dancing, you'll really love this movie. She dresses to the nines occasionally, and it's a lot of fun. It has aeronautics. It has sailing. It has competition. It has a couple of breasts in it. It has everything you need to keep you interested. And then at the top of the whole thing, it's got Matthew Modine, who at that time had come off of Vision Quest. He was in his in-between career, and he was strutting his stuff very well. And you can see how his career has progressed by doing movies like Wind. This is the only movie in my life that I can recall seeing for the first time and then getting to the end of it and rewinding the VCR just so I could see it again. I'm not talking about seeing it and then seeing it a couple years later going, that was a great movie. I actually sat back for another 2 hours and 6 minutes and saw this movie again because it was that good. Now, am I biased? Do I love sailing? Yes, I do. So what else can I tell you about the movie to get you in it? Well, I can tell you this. It's produced by Francis Ford Coppola. He made sure that this movie would not only be fun, be good, be excellent, but would tell a story inside of it on the Coppola scale. And you have to, a lot of people don't understand that. Coppola did other movies than Apocalypse Now. He was involved in Patton, which is one of my favorite movies, and I was just at the Patton Museum on Memorial Day weekend. And he did movies like this. He stretched himself, which is something that I really like, because unlike Kubrick, who stretched himself way too far and we can't keep up with him, Francis Ford Coppola kept to the point. He keeps to his stories. He makes sure that the directors, the writers, the scenes, the production itself, everything's going to come together and make that point. It's directed by Carroll Ballard. Again, see it. I love it. You'll love it. And if you love sailing, you'll love Wind. Thank you for YouTube West. I'm Bob West, and this has been Studio 7.